Do you like content? Oh boy, I hope you do. Because in this video, we're gonna dive into exactly how you can create content utilizing our free content calendar template in Sofdr. First and foremost, you can check out this amazing content calendar template by going to sofdr.io/templates. As with all of our other templates, it's very easy to check this out by pressing preview. And you'll see right here that there are a few different options when I press sign in, a content manager and a campaign manager. Both of those are gonna have different types of access levels as there are different user groups inside of Sofdr. So if I wanted to get started using this template, I'd press use template, and then I would connect it to a data source of my choosing. For this instance, I'm gonna use Airtable. Then I would copy this to a base in Airtable and then press create application. This template has a lot of different tools and options within it. So let's dive right into it. First and foremost, when I go to the base right here, you'll see that we have a few different tables. Users, which would have the campaign and content managers as shown previously, then the content pipeline, the campaigns and the results. So essentially the results are gonna be related to those different campaigns we talked about. Campaigns are going to be different marketing and content campaigns that we did. So all the different campaigns are gonna be right here along with their different creators. And then we have the content pipeline. So this content pipeline is gonna have a bunch of different statuses like approved, on hold, in progress, and pretty much have the entire step-by-step process for what it means to make content. So if I wanted to view this from the campaign manager standpoint, I'm gonna make a quick magic link after having published the template, and you'll see that I'm logged in as a campaign manager. Now, campaign managers have the ability to, when I click here on the homepage, see the entire content pipeline. They'll be able to filter it by the different channels. So like blog, for example, or email, Instagram, Facebook. Let's check out the different emails right here. Awesome. And this is the content pipeline page. So we get to see more of the data that is going along with this content. So this is the content details page. We'll see right here that we have the due date, a description of it, an image right here, the creator, the campaign manager, what its status is, the channels that it's a part of, and we can also press edit content to edit this data within here. So say for example, I wanted to change the due date to, I don't know, November 12th, and press update content. You see right here, this changed it to November 12th. Or say after it being approved, I also wanted to make it live. I could do that, pressing live and pressing update content. Now, this isn't the only thing that campaign managers can see. They can obviously go to the content pipeline page here from the top header, but they also can see the status board, which is going to showcase all of the different content in a board view. And we can move these from left to right, and we'll change the status property. So you can see if I click in this guy, the status is going to be in progress, which is what that spot on the board was. Now, when it goes to the calendar page, I also can see all this from a calendar perspective. So I can change this by month, view, or week, or day. But say, for example, I wanted to go back to November of 22 to talk about the beach essentials, or to check out the beach essentials. If I click on this, it'll give us a bunch of the different information about this in a little preview modal. But if I wanted to go into the entirety of the page, I can press open page right there. Now, when it comes to the content manager side, you'll see pretty quickly, it is very similar to what I just showcased, except there's one difference between the two. Lee right here, who is a content manager. See right here, we have campaigns overview, campaign calendar. But for the other one, which was the campaign manager, we have the create campaign option. So that's the distinction here. And we don't have the reporting view. So like as a content manager, I can just see the campaigns here. I don't have access to actually creating a campaign. I can take a look at things from the campaign calendar as well. But like I said, for someone like Bailey, who would be a campaign manager, they however can see the extra stuff here. So if I go into this view once again, you can see that if I press create campaign, I actually have access to this. And in the add campaign page, you'll see that these are mapped after they're filled out in a form to the campaigns table inside of Airtable. It's mapped to the name, start date, end date, the budget that you manually put in. And then there's a hidden field, which essentially takes the logged in person's name and has that value end up being mapped to the campaign manager. And then there's a status property as well. So for example, if I were to create a new campaign, it'd just be test campaign, make it today and end at the end of the month, say $5,000, and make it a planning campaign. After pressing add campaign, since I am logged in as Bailey Mirza, a campaign that was in the planning phase and made just now with the campaign manager was Bailey Mirza. Now you can obviously change this to have other information. If you wanted to change any of these different things, you definitely could change the fields within here or remove any of them. All you'd have to do would be press the three dots and delete them, or press add field and then add any of the options of your choosing and then map them to a specific field. Then when it comes to campaign results, the campaign managers are going to be able to see this in the reporting page as well. We can filter it to the different campaigns by channel that we have here. So things like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, AdWords, and display campaigns. So if I click on this guy, I can see how much spend there was, and then a lot of the different metadata, which is really cool. And the success that I had here, but basically just because it was what the campaign success status is. Overall, this is a really great template though. I love the fact that you can add all the different content to a centralized database that has a multitude of different views and then analyze the campaigns afterwards. If you like this video and want to see more about all the different use cases that we have here at Software, make sure to check out our entire playlist on this. We have made a myriad of different videos on all of these templates, and we'd love to hear more about what kind of templates you're looking for and what kind of videos we can make to help you learn how software works. Make sure to smash that like button, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.